We've talked about hybrid cloud. We've talked about now data migration. I want to move to a new paradigm, which is building for the intelligent cloud, the intelligent edge. Now, while this paradigm is new, the distributed architecture spanning cloud and edge still remains the same and aligned with hybrid, that durable design principle of being consistent and comprehensive, both across your development environment, your security, and your management. And if you focus on the intelligent edge for just a second, we have a continuum of edge solutions. But one product that we're going to look at right now is Azure Data Box Edge, which is an AI-enabled edge computing appliance that works in tandem with Azure. To talk more about this, I'd love to introduce Talal and Andrew.
Thank you, Julia. So we're going to talk about the intelligent cloud and intelligent edge.
Yes, we are.
And we have two great products that fit and are important parts of the intelligent cloud and intelligent edge strategy.
Data Box Edge and Data Box Gateway.
Excellent. You've been working on these two products for how long?
Over a year and a half now. So it's an exciting day.
Excellent, excellent. Azure is actually unique in the sense that we can position it as both the cloud, and then we can extend the great capabilities from Azure with the application model, the security model, the management model, all the way to the edge. And this is where Data Box Edge and Data Box Gateway are a great fit for what we're going to talk about today. One of the biggest things that are happening in the industry is that we have over 20 billion IoT devices that just generate an enormous amount of data and go through the life cycle of data, from the collection and aggregation of this data, the processing of the data, all the machine learning and intelligence that has to be applied to derive insights from the data, all the way to deriving actions from this data. And then we've built those two great products to go and do that. But before we go into what those products are, why don't you walk us through what Data Box Edge and Data Box Gateway are trying to solve, Andrew?
Yes. So all those devices you mentioned are generating data outside the cloud, and the vast majority of them are generating data outside your traditional data centers, out in the world in various places, out at the edge. And so in those locations, there's limited bandwidth, there's high network latency, and internet connectivity can be very expensive. So with all that data, you want to be able to process it locally so you can get a result quickly and close to where the data is generated, and then modify and figure out what the right pieces are to upload to the cloud.
This is great. And then because Azure is extended to the edge in this case, and it uses the same design principles that we have in hybrid, where we bring in the consistency of the application model, the management model, the security model. It makes it easier from a skills perspective as well as from an application portability to take those workloads from the cloud to the edge.
Yes, you can use Azure ML to train models in the cloud, you know, develop your model. You can run it in the cloud, but if you have those locations where you have that limited bandwidth, you can also run that same ML, Azure ML model at the edge.
This is pretty awesome. So why don't you walk us through what Data Box Edge is?
Yes, so Data Box Edge is an AI-enabled edge compute device, and it has an Intel Aria 10 FPGA in it to accelerate your ML inferencing at the edge. And its compute capabilities allow you to run containers. So like that Azure ML model I mentioned, you can run that in a container on there to do your ML inferencing, and you can also push other containers to the device to do processing at the edge using the other compute in the device. It has two CPUs with 10 cores each and 128 gigs of RAM to do your compute. It also does network data transfer. So it exposes SMB and NFS on your network, and you can transfer data to it, local network copy, and then it abstracts the copy to the cloud for you, either to block blob, page blob, or Azure files.
I believe we have a customer story, one of the customers that we partnered with to get a ton of feedback as we were building the product. So can you walk us through the scenario?
Yeah, so it's Cree, who's using it in their manufacturing, where they take images as their parts go down the manufacturing line, and those images they use for quality control purposes and for remediation if there's an issue in the future. And so they need to store those for an extended period of time for compliance purposes. And so they're using Azure Storage for that.
I can't wait to see the video.
It's very cool.
Let's see the video.
The key attribute of Cree is innovation. We are the first company to commercialize silicon carbide. We would consider our products a generational opportunity. In an electric vehicle, when you build your inverter using silicon carbide components, your car can go further. So it has a very significant impact.
Cree is experiencing tremendous growth. Part of that process requires a tremendous amount of storage, and we've positioned the Data Box Edge to provide that continued growth in storage without hampering the business.
DataBox Edge is a very cool solution where we can capture the data gets stored in the cloud, then the access to data is a lot easier.
Part of the process for our manufacturing facility is we take photos of each wafer that comes out, 1,000+ photos of each individual die on that wafer. Microsoft DataBox Edge allows us to trickle the data up to the cloud on a bandwidth or scheduled meter. We don't need to have administrators looking at it.
What we will be doing with the DataBox Edge and having the capacity to implement artificial intelligence into the process is fantastic.
One of the things we've identified moving forward is the ability to use Azure's machine learning to teach a model to identify the same defects we do today on-prem. What this will allow us to do is to leverage the IoT Edge functionality to be able to push that model down to it and identify these defects much quicker as we scale the solutions out.
DataBox Edge gives us an ability to focus on what we are good at, pure innovation.
What a great story. On behalf of Microsoft, I really have to say thank you to all the people in Cree for making that product better and for all the feedback that helped us build this great technology.
Yes, they were a great partner throughout our preview and gave us lots of great feedback to help improve the quality of the product.
Excellent, good. So now there is the second product that we're going to talk about, which is DataBox Gateway. So can you walk us through what DataBox Gateway is?
So DataBox Gateway is a storage gateway. So it has all the data transfer capabilities of DataBox Edge. In fact, it's the same storage gateway in both products, but DataBox Gateway is a virtual appliance. So you deploy that on your own hardware, in your environment, on your hypervisor, so you can size it appropriate for your environment and the amount of data you need to transfer.
This is wonderful. So can you let me know that you can actually use both, in some cases, DataBox Edge and DataBox Gateway?
Yes, in fact, we have a preview customer doing that. In some of their locations, they don't have space for additional hardware, so they deployed DataBox Gateway in those smaller offices on existing hardware, while they're in their larger offices, they've deployed a couple of DataBox Gateways, or DataBox Edges.
So this is great. So those two products complement each other in many cases as well.
Yes.
So now let's move to the business model and the customer experience. How would I, as a customer, go and order any of those two?
Yes. So one of our design principles with both of these products was to make it very simple for customers to get them. You know, with a piece of hardware, normally there's an extended budgeting process, licensing process, going through your CapEx approvals and everything.
Yes.
So we try to make it very simple. Basically, you order both of them from the Azure portal, and you're subscribing to a service just like any other Azure service, so it shows up on your Azure bill as OpEx.
So this is the one of the things in being cloud managed. It is an Azure service. You go to the portal, you go and manage any of the devices or the gateways that you have. So what's the cost model for this?
So the cost model for DataBox Edge is $695 a month for the DataBox Edge service, the DataBox Edge piece of hardware, and support for that hardware.
Excellent. And for DataBox Gateway?
DataBox Gateway is $125 a month.
$125 a month, which is downloadable basically from the Azure portal.
When you go to the portal and subscribe, you'll get a link to download the virtual appliance.
Great. So now we've known what those two products are. Let's go through some real use cases of how our customers can get value out of this great technology.
Right. One of the first use cases is really about edge compute. So data pre-processing or just running cloud-managed compute at the edge. So as you mentioned earlier, there's lots of things generating lots of data outside the cloud right now, and there's limited network bandwidth and that latency that I talked about. So you need to do some processing of that data before you transfer it to the cloud.
Are you going to show us the demo on how this capability can work?
We do have a demo here. And so I have a short video. It's about 2 minutes of one of the entrances to the garage in one of the buildings here at Microsoft. And it was filmed at 8 a.m., so there's not a lot of cars coming in because most of our engineers don't get up that early. And so you can see one went by. There's a couple other cars that go by in the 2 minutes, but there's lots of empty driveway. Now, if I had lots of bandwidth, I could just copy that to the cloud and let it be processed.
So in this scenario, without doing anything, you basically end up with a very, very large video file of a camera feed that is running 24/7, and then you're trying to apply intelligence to save and detect which frames has cars and which doesn't.
Right. What are the interesting parts of the video rather than uploading all of that to the cloud? And you know, this is one camera from one entrance. There's multiple entrances in every building, and you can imagine
which ends up multiplying so many files by that much data.
Exactly. So what we're going to do is we're going to use Azure ML to process this locally at the edge. So the way DataBox Edge works, for compute is there's an input share where your data comes into, and then there's a notification sent into IoT Edge, which is where your containers run, to tell your containers that new files arrived and it should be processed. And what we'll see here is on my output share, I now have a car folder and another folder.
So if you go into the car folder, we'll see a bunch of frames with cars.
Right, we have 7 frames, each with a car in them. And so we've detected the 7 interesting bits out of that 2-minute video by processing that video to pull out 1 frame per second and then running Azure ML on it on the FPGA and the data box edge.
And this can be applied in many fields, correct? It can be applied for safety, for security.
Exactly. And so for the purposes of the demo, we also created the other folder. And so you can see I have 114 frames here that are just empty driveways, and there's no need for me to upload all that data to the cloud. So I found the interesting pieces of data so I can optimize the amount of data I'm uploading to the cloud to match my bandwidth.
This is a great demo. Now, you can have multiple cameras and multiple feeds as well. So it's not just one. You can multiply this by as many cameras as you have.
Depending on the camera resolution and what ML models you're using to process it, you can have multiple cameras hooked up to your data box edge.
Great. So now I'm going to talk about my favorite use case, which is machine learning and deep learning.
Yes.
Using the built-in FPGA from Intel Aria 10. I think it's a great capability. It allows you to train and use Azure machine learning to train a model and use inferencing at the edge using the capability with DataBox Edge. It's one of the great stories I think you've contributed to with Microsoft Research, where we partnered with one of the cities here in Washington to test the safety of public safety for people crossing an intersection.
It's a great smart city demo.
So as you are going to see in a minute, basically people are trying to cross an intersection on a crosswalk, and there is a counter for when that crosswalk is going to turn red for them and it's not safe to cross anymore. But then if there is anything that is prohibiting them from completing that journey in the time that they have, the camera and the intelligence in DataBox Edge can detect that they haven't crossed safely and will give them more time.
Right.
It will give a signal to give them more time basically to cross and it is safe to do so.
Yes. And it's a great example of processing the data at the edge and taking action based on that result quickly and close to where the data is being generated.
And I believe Microsoft Research and your team are working with other cities as well to make the smart city, urban mobility scenarios more common in our use cases today.
Yes. I mean, there's lots of other ways you could use this in a smart city. I mean, even with traffic cameras, where you may be monitoring your traffic cameras from your intersections, and if there's an accident, you can notify 911 to come resolve the issue, help people, or you can even look at that data to see what led up to that accident. Again, you don't need, when everything's working normally, you don't need to upload that data, but you can detect accidents and other things and take action.
This is a great use of AI in this scenario, and I really love this use case. Can you walk us through the last use case that we have today?
Yes, and the last use case is data transfer. And so we saw that in my demo where there's a subset of the data being uploaded, but DataBox Edge and DataBox Gateway both expose SMB and NFS shares and allow that data to be transferred to block blob, page blob, or Azure files. And they both have standard, typical storage gateway type capabilities like bandwidth throttling. So you can set restrictions on, you know, during normal business hours, only use this much of my network, but overnight, you know, you can have as much bandwidth as is available to transfer data for you.
And this one is applicable to both DataBox Edge and DataBox Gateway.
It is, yes.
Excellent. So today, this is where the exciting part happens.
It is, yes.
We are pleased to announce that both DataBox Edge and DataBox Gateway are generally available. So can you let us know first with DataBox Gateway?
Yes, so DataBox Gateway is available worldwide. You can go to the Azure portal and subscribe to it and download the virtual machine today and stand one up and get going.
Excellent. And for DataBox Edge, because it's appliance, it has a little bit of a different model?
It has a little bit of a different model in that it's only available in the United States and European Union countries. We will be expanding that, but initially, right now, that's where it's available.
And then please go to the link and find out how you can acquire one or both of those two great pieces of technology. For that, we'd like to say thank you so much for listening. This has been a great experience, and it's a really good milestone for Microsoft today.